Hi, my name is Marcel Beugelsdijk from the Netherlands, and in this video I'll show you how to count the same consecutive results in Power Query. As an example, I will use the result from rolling a single dice 100,000 times. The end result will be a pivot table showing dice results 1 to 6 in columns, and in the rows the number of same consecutive results in a row. For example, how many times did we have two consecutive ones in a row, etc. First, we need 100,000 random numbers. These are between 0 and 1, so we need to multiply by 6, add 0.5 and round the result. Now we want to group by consecutive results. If you just use group by, then you get the overall count of each result. The magic trick comes from the fifth argument of table.group, GroupKind.Local, meaning that a group is created for each change of the value being grouped. Before pivoting the results, I adjust the format of the results from the dice rolls to text. Now we want a pivot table and have results from the dice rolls both as column header and their counts in the matrix. Unfortunately, you can only select count consecutive rolls as values, meaning that they won't be used as row labels. So let's adjust the argument for the values column to result from dice roll. Now we get the desired results, but with the wrong column order. In order to fix that, I just supply the text values 1 to 6 to the column label argument of table.pivot. As a final step, I add a column with totals. Now we can load the results to Excel and do some formatting. So if you want to count consecutive values in Power Query, don't forget that highly secret fifth column argument of table.group, groupkind.local.